Very well, here we are. We're alive right here. Book of Poopa Weems. Say here. Alrighty, let's see here. Let's read the book of Colossians. Paul, apostle of Yeshua HaMashiach, through the will of Elohim, and Timothy, our brother, to the saints and faithful brethren in HaMashiach who are in Colossae. Cracky to you and peace from Elohim the Father and the King Yeshua HaMashiach. There's a little one over here at the end. Let's see what that for verse 2. We give well reception to the Elohim and Father of our King Yeshua HaMashiach, praying always for you. Since we heard of your faith in HaMashiach Yeshua, of your love for all the saints, because of the hope that is stored up for you in Heaven, of that you heard before in the word of the truth of the message that has arrived to you, as it has also in all the world, and is bringing forth fruities. A little one there on the fruities. Growing. Fruities. Add and growing. So fruities represent some growth here. Some fruities, man. Some fruities. Need some fruities. Yeah, could use some fruit. Yeah, could use some fruit. Mmm, yum, yum. Yeah, could use some fruit. I'll make me a little fruity note up here. Fruity. It's growth. Hey, I'm trying to fruity some greens, man. Fruity some greens. Fruity there. There's a fruity line there. I always take my little ink pen here for the sharpness of the point, a little orange color there. Alright. It's bringing forth fruity, as it is also among you, since the birth you heard and knew the Gracchi of Elohim in truth. As you also learn from Epaphras, our dear fellow servant, who is a faithful minister in HaMashiach on your behalf, who also declared to us your love in the spit. For this reason, we also, since the birth we heard of it, do not cease to pray for you, and to ask that you may be filled with all knowledge. Ooh. Now looky here. Looky here now. This word called ask. Now this word called ask here has to do with with some praying. So we'll put this over here. And to the disassemble the word here, it's P-Ray. P-Ray, man, P-Ray. So we're going to draw little lines here. Make some little notes to the word ask there. All right. Now, the thing that they're asking for, that you be filled of the knowledge of His will in all wisdom and spiritual understanding. Spiritual understanding. And there's the word walk. Put the word walk up here. The word walk equals to speak love, love knowledge. Called the sin. Alright, so we'll take the word walk here. Make a little line there. Oop. Some boopty boops there. Yeah. That you may walk worthy of the Elohim, fully pleasing Him. Now, you notice this word ask right here. Ephesians 1:15-17. I have a little note next to it. Gentiles eat the pork chop. Ephesians 1:15. See if it has anything to do with ask. Therefore I also, after I heard of your faith in the King Yeshua, and your love for all the saints, there's that word love, do not cease to give thanks or well reception for you, making mention of you in my prayers, that, and then this is the thing that he's asking in his prayers. So I'm going to put a little note here. As King, it's the book of Ephesians, chapter 1, verse 17. Make a mention of you in my prayers, verse 16. That the Creator of our King, Yeshua HaMashiach, the Father of glory, would give to you the spirit of wisdom and revelation and the knowledge of Him, the eyes of your understanding being enlightened, that you know the hope of His calling, the riches of His glory, of the glory of His inheritance in the saints. Notice here we have saints here. Saints, not church. Notice he didn't say the word church here, he said the word saints. I'm finding that there's a difference between the word church and the word saints, man. Verse 19, and the thing that is exceeding greatness of his power toward us who accept, according to the working of his mighty power. So, I'm gonna make me a little notey here. Make me a little notey. Skittle little little the butts. Make me a little notey. The word ask here. It's 1 Colossians 1:9. So we'll be over here to the word ask. Put a little 1 Colossians 1:9 or Colossians 1:9. Col:9. Just a little tiny little thing. That's why it's nice to have this orange fine print, man. And then we'll remember where the asking is. Ephesians 1:17. We'll put this ask over here. Ephesians 1:17. Alrighty. So there we are with some footy. Some bare footy. Now, some fruit. Some fruit. I'm reading the end of Philippians over here. On the opposite page, it says, Philippians 4, verse 17, not that I ask the gift, however that I seek the fruit that abounds to your account. Abounds to your account, man. So that we saw that we're fruity there. And, fruity growth, man, fruity growth. Some fruit, man. Some fruity growth. So we'll take this word fruit, draw a little line from Colossians over here to the other side of the page of the book of the end of Philippians. So that when we read that verse, we'll read it again like this. Not that I seek the gift, however, I seek the growth. Ah, the growth. The fruity growth, man, the fruity growth. The fruity growth that abounds to your count. Account. I like this next verse, though. Philippians verse, chapter 4, verse 18. Indeed, I have all and abound. Indeed, I have all and abound. Indeed, I have all that abound. I have all that abound. Now, it could be that Paul's saying, I have all growth. I have all the fruit, man. The fruity pebbles. Indeed, of the fruity pebbles, or have received. Looking at the little side notes here, I have a little one, a number one next to the word have, just before the H. A stav of the H in the word have. So let's read it. Indeed, I have all and abound. I am full, having received from Epaphroditus the thing sent from you, a sweet smelling aroma, an acceptable sack of rice, well pleasing to Elohim. Sack of rice, man. So, going back over here to the book of Colossae, chapter 1, verse 9, where it says, "For this reason, we also, since the day we heard it, do not cease to pray for you and to ask that you may be filled of the knowledge of his will and all wisdom and spiritual understanding, that you may walk worthy of the Elohim, of the King, fully pleasing him, being fruitful, being fruity, in every well labor, and increasing in the knowledge of Elohim." So we look at that word ask there, and it reminds me of a little more insight to that word ask over here in the book of the Johns, the throne room books. As we're sitting on the throne, pooping out the fruit. So, do me a quick little look around here and see if I can find me a note on the word ask. Completo First John only has 4 or 5 chapters in it. There's the word ask right there. 5 chapters for the book of Ask, for the book of 1 John. This is the first throne room right here. Alright. So let's look at this word ask here. Now let's make some notes first. We're 1 John 3:22, so we'll put that to the word ask here in the book of Colossae. Make a little 1, a little J in. A colon and a 22. And then we'll be over here. Colossians 1:9 for the ask. And we did Ephesians also from my memory. So we'll put Ephesians 1:17. Yep. There we are. Now, let's go to verse 21 of chapter 3 of the book of 1 John. It says, "Beloved, if our heart does not condemn us, if our heart does not condemn us, we have confidence toward Elohim." Condom. Now think of that word condom. Do a little word study on that. That word condom. Verse 22. "And the thing that we ask, we receive from him." Let's read that again. "Beloved, if our heart does not condemn us, we have confidence toward Elohim. And the thing that we ask, we receive from him, because we keep his commandments and do those things that are pleasing in his sight." I'd like to add on here, we keep his new commandments, not the old commandments, the new commandments. "And this is his new commandment," verse 23, "that we should accept on the name of his son Yeshua HaMashiach and love one another as he gave us command." Sure, we ask here. looking at the little line that I drew here, ask. Should be some more asking things here. The thing that we're asking for is some fruity growth for our brother. Some fruity growth. We're not asking for Cadillacs and new cars and all that other stuff. That's not in this book. Fruity growth in the knowledge of the sin. That's what we're asking for. Fruity growth, man. Ah, here we are. So we have here a 322. The 322, and this ask over here in chapter 5 of 1 John is five fifteen. So we're gonna put a little 515 in there. I'm not gonna put the name of the book. I'm just gonna put the number 5:15, because that lets me know that I'm still in the same book, just a different chapter. So when we're over here, chapter 5, verse 15, we read on the ask thing, it says here, starting in verse 13, he says, these things I have written to you who accept in the name of the Son of Elohim, that you may know that you have eternal life. And that you may continue to accept in the name of the Son of Elohim. Verse 14. Now this is the confidence that we have in Him, that if we ask according to His will, it says here, if we ask anything according to His will. I don't like that word anything, because it leads people down the wrong path, man. The old phrase anything goes rings in mind. That if we ask specifically according to His will, there we are. Hold on here. My computer's on rest break here. Let's do system preference. Let's look at the rest screen here. Energy saver. Put the hard disk to sleep when possible. When possible. Close to 3 hours. Put the computers to sleep for after close to 3 hours. Boop boops. Look at the displays. See what we have here for. Nope. Mouse and keyboard. Let's get the keyboard. Now illuminate the keyboard, low light conditions. Turn off computer when not in use, never. Modifier keys cancel. Hmm. double mouse, Bluetooth, keyboard shortcuts, trackpad, I disabled my trackpad. Ignore trackpad input, ignore trackpad when mouse is present. I wonder where this, look at energy saver again. Options, sleep. Schedule. Schedule. Hide details, show details. Well, I'm not finding anything right offhand yet, so specifically was the word that was in my mind. Specifically. Them Bible translators done put that word anything in there on purpose to fool everyone. Alright, now remember, we're in the book of 1 John now, correlating the word ask in the book of Colossians chapter 1. Now, chapter verse 14 of chapter 5, 1 John. Now this is the confidence that we have in him, in Elohim, that if we ask specifically according to his will, he hears us. And if we know that he hears us, the specificity we ask, we know that we have the petitions that we asked of him. And here's the explanation of the thing, that specific thing that we're always asking for, that we ask Elohim for through prayer. Verse 16. If anyone sees his brother sinning a sin that does not lead to death, he will ask, and he will give him life for those who commit sin not leading to death. There is sin leading to death. I do not say that he should pray for that. Now, he gives us in these other verses a little more insight of some clues as to sin unto death. Verse 17, all unrighteousness is sin, and there is sin not leading to death. We know that whoever is born of Elohim does not sin. However, he who has been born of Elohim keeps himself. And a wicked one does not touch him. Now, with all the information that we know of the sin, we know that Paul is speaking of eternal death in these sentences here. And when he says, we know that whoever is born of Elohim does not sin, he's saying, does not commit the sin. Going around the whole earth teaching and encouraging everyone to strive after the summary of the law, known as, love our neighbors as ourselves. all the other differential phrases of it. So, take a little thingamajigger here, make some little notes here. Colossians 1:9. So, you know, when he's saying here, if anyone sees his brother sinning a sin that does not lead to death, he will ask, and Elohim will give him life. And then he says, there is a sin leading to death. I do not say that he should pray about that. Now notice the word ask here and pray are used interconnectedly. So it's as though it's the same word and it's dealing with the same priority, and that is praying for salvation for our brothers. Now, when he says there is sin leading to death, he's referring to those vessels or those brothers or those people whom Elohim created purposely. Vessels of destruction. Those vessels that were created to go to hell. So Paul is saying, don't pray that they're not going to go to hell. Don't try to pray them out of it. Don't pray him out of it, Elohim's saying. He says, you'll be wasting your breath. Because Elohim's already made up his decision. Long time ago, when he first created everything, he decided these certain people are going to go to hell. Might be a bit on the blunt side. I could ease the statement and turn it into a chocolate frosted cake if I want to. Like this, I could say, Elohim knew certain men that he created would reject him. That's the chocolate frosting cake way of saying it. So, we know that Elohim is in control of everything, and everything that is established has been established through him. So it's just as though he created them to go to hell, even though he did also create them with the option and the choice to reject him. That's one of those subjects that are very wondrous in my mind. How that the details and the interconnections of how that plays out. How it plays out. Of course, here in verse 18 he says, we know that whoever is born of Elohim does not sin. However, he who is born of Elohim keeps himself, and the wicked one does not touch him. Now, it's not that we keep ourselves, it's that Elohim decided before the foundations of the earth that he was going to make sure we kept ourselves. Kept ourselves from what? Kept ourselves from? Question mark. Scratch that word what. That's a fiction word. Keeps us from going around striving after and encouraging one another and our brothers to, we should be striving after loving our neighbor as ourselves. In other words, the summary of the law. Why, with all that explanation that I just said, this is why Paul says this in Colossians chapter 1 verse 9. For this reason we also, since the day we heard of it, do not cease to pray for you and to ask that you may be filled of the knowledge. To be filled, man. Be filled in with all the information that there is, all the details that there is to know. To be filled of the knowledge of His will. The will of Elohim is to accept His Son and the knowledge of the sin. To be filled of the knowledge of His will and all wisdom and spiritual understanding, that you may walk worthy. Make sense? So, you know, there is a benefit to Elohim's trust. When we enter into Elohim's trust, there are benefits. There's the benefit of the Holy Spirit that enters into us. So it's like Elohim lives in our heart now. And He's saying to us, all right, read this, read that, read that. Read this letter, read that letter. And then He'll cause a particular word to jump out at us. And we'll say, I don't understand that. And He'll cause us to remember, oh, I read that word in another book somewhere. Let's see if I can find it. So go around searching. Hey, where did I see that word before? And seeing how I'm on the throne room most of the time when I'm reading all this stuff, all these words, words of life. I'd be doing a lot of searching. Where's the word? 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 I'll be looking for little pen notes. I'll be looking for pre-printed titles that are already there. You know? You know, and I could, and I take the long route. The reason I take the long route is because I could easily just lift up my poopy butt with the butt cheeks rubbing together as I walk over to the next room to find the biblical concordance. It's a book that's that thick. that tells us where every word is at. I could do that. However, I only do that once I finish my doo-doo and I'm walking throughout the rest of the sunshine or cloud shine and I'm just totally dumbfounded as to where it's at. I've tried, I can't find it. Then as a last resort, then I go to the concordance. So when I read one word somewhere else, and the Holy Spirit in me, a little benefit, part of the benefit package of being in trust, Elohim's trust, he's in there, he's saying, hey, remember you read that word somewhere else. Of course, he's like saying it in such a way that it's my own thoughts. So I'm actually saying to myself, oh yeah, I remember. I read that word somewhere else. Although Elohim is in control of the thought. He's the one that gave it birth. Although it was at my discretion and my option to put the thought there. Or to, you know, it was as though it was my own option, is the thing that I'm saying. And it's the same idea where a man is sinning the sin that leads to death. It's that same explanation that I just explained 10 minutes prior. So, when I'm searching for that other word in another book somewhere that I read, I'm thinking, man, where's the book? Where's it at? So I'm going through book, looking, see if I can find a quick reference first, going through it quick, look for some pen, and there'll be times where all of a sudden, where my mind will say, you read it, you wrote something in green ink, big letters, in the upper right-hand side of the page. I'll remember something like that. So I'll just be flipping through quickly, looking for those big green letters on the upper right-hand side of the page. Or the lower inside of the page. You know, things like that. So, when I do find where the other word is, and I read around it, I find more explanation to the first place that I read it, where I says to myself, oh man, I'm starting to see something here around this word. Pictures are starting to form. Ideas, knowledge, wisdom, understanding, spiritual understanding is starting to make its way to the forefront and reveal itself. And I'm thinking, And so it's like the quest to quench that hunger. That hunger, man. Spiritual food, man. Man don't live on bread alone. Through every word of Elohim. Because, or I should say, the importance of this Holy Spirit-led hunger is that when I fill this brain with knowledge and wisdom and understanding, spiritual understanding, when I fill this brain that's connected to my heart, when I feel this brain, all that wisdom and knowledge and understanding starts to mature. It grows, starts to get fruity. Wow, this is fruity stuff here. See what I'm saying? Starts to get fruity, man. It starts wanting to grow because it's taking in nutrients and being watered, fertilizer and all that stuff, manure. And as my maturity starts to increase, my confidence levels increase. And when my confidence levels increase, my standing abilities increase. In other words, to stand strong on the wisdom of Elohim and the knowledge of the sin. So you see? So let's and there was a word yesterday that I was doing a study on. It's the word affection. I went into the regular dictionary in there, old dictionary, 1828 dictionary. Went there and started reading definitions of affection. And man, did I find out some things. The word affection. A-F-F. Affect. Not E-F-F, not effect. Affect. Because I was looking at the root word. Affection. So I thought root word. Affect. And one of the definitions had to do with animation, fiction. Like cartoon characters, like making voices, and sound effects and stuff like that. Effect. Very interesting. Very interesting. And it made me take a look at my life and my personalities. And so we'll end on that note at 47 minutes 50 something seconds, and we'll stop this before our internet disconnects. There's someone riding their bicycle in the bike path there behind the fence. Farewell.